Addiction start early. Are you with me? Coke junkies at 8, dope junkies at 18. Protect the brains of your children. Stop feeding them junk food all the time, sugaring them to death, and messing up their teeth. Stop feeding them donuts before school and wondering why they can't be still in the classroom. How can they learn with all that sugar on the brain? Kids love sugar and hate greens and beans. I smell a rat. I smell a rat, friends. The devil knows that spinach produces brain power, and that grape fights tumors, and that broccoli causes the skin to glow. But how many of us crave these things? I smell a rat! Young folk face temptations that we did not have to face. Are you with me, friends? GM musicians, I need you. Face temptations that we did not have to face. They are facing a 2007 devil. Watch out for the internet, the cell phone, the Nintendo, and even the cartoons. They're getting a little too graphic nowadays, some of these cartoons. Jesus said, suffer or allow the children to come to him and forbid them what, friends? Forbid them not. This is a warning, friends, to all of those who hinder their own children. Do you not know our children watch us? We hinder them by our own actions from following Jesus. Christian education in school and in church is hindered greatly because it's not seen first in the home. Friends of mine, we start in the home. We start in the school afterwards. Don't send your kids to Christian school hoping that they'll just save your children who has the devil in them. You got to get the devil out of them through your home. Bring your kids to Christian school so that they can be trained. Just don't dump anything into the Christian school. Are you with me, friends? Mold and make your children. The whole purpose of Christian school anyway was to train young folk to be some missionaries and to go out and to learn all these other things as well. But we made church school, some of them, a school where we dump kids hoping that we'll get the devil out of them. Friends, God says it starts in your home. The Lord is moving on some of you now because you have a burden with your children. The Lord is moving on some of you to invest with Christian education. It's a good investment, friends. It's a good investment. The Lord is moving on some of you to be better examples to your children because you know sometimes they caught you cursing. They caught you gossiping. They caught you telling lies and teaching them to tell little lies. My mama, tell them my mama's not home. That's a lie. They caught you being a hypocrite. They caught you doing this and doing that. And you know that every time they catch you, Jesus said, forbid them not. You're blocking them from getting a meal. Friends, it's a terrible responsibility to be a parent because your child is watching you. That same child that can grow up to be either the devil or the most powerful Christian in the world. That same child that can grow up and either go to hell or go to heaven. Your child is watching you. It's watching you. I know I watch my parents. I watch them. I can tell you every negative thing they did and every positive thing they did. I watched them. And your children are watching you. Make sure, friends, that they see Jesus. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for your word today. Lord, we pray that your people got the message. Lord, these are the last days, and you're about to come. You're about to come, and you're looking for character. Let's do it now, church. Let's do it. It's time for the Holy Ghost to talk. Let him talk.
Surrender all.